Hi friends, in this video let us discuss the crisp relations in that operations and properties, how the operations on crisp relations will be and what are the properties of crisp relations. As we have already studied the crisp sets, so many of them are more or less same compared to crisp sets, even the operations and the properties. Let us see how these are same or how what is the difference between crisp sets and crisp relations. Small differences are there, so once we know the differences, then we can go ahead and we can simply explore them separately, crisp sets and crisp relations. Let us see. Yeah, we have already discussed this these topics to learn, so these are the topics we have to learn. The crisp relations, under this crisp relations we have already covered Cartesian product and cardinality of crisp relations. Now in this video we will cover operations on crisp relations, properties of crisp relations. In the next video we will cover composition and fuzzy relations and tolerance and equivalence relations. So these are the topics we need to cover completely, and in this video we will cover the green colored part, operations on crisp relations and properties of crisp relations. Let us see how these will be. Operations on crisp relations. So let us see, let's take two relations. One is R and second one is S, are two separate relations on Cartesian universe, capital X cross capital Y. And let us see. So there are two things, two relations are very important. One is the null relation and the second one is the complete relation. And these matrices are shown as O and capital E respectively. For null relation it is O and the complete relation it's E. That means all the elements in this matrix, maybe if it is a null relation, the null relational matrix should be, all elements should be zeros. And if it is a complete relation, the all elements in the matrices is obviously 1. Let us see. Yeah, an example of 3 by 3 form of the O and E matrices are given here. Let us see. Yeah, this is O and this is capital E. So O is the null relation, that means all are zeros, and capital E is the complete relation, so all are ones. So these are, we will use all these things in our further things, maybe in operations or in the properties. Let's go to operations now. So these are the operations on crisp relations. So first operation is, as we know, it's union, R union X. Now here it will be analogous to capital X R union S X comma Y. So this is the analogous term for R union S into relations. So this is the relation such that X of R union S of X comma Y is equal to max of X of R of X comma Y and X of S comma X of X comma Y. That means here we need to see the maximum value of relation R and relation S. So what is the maximum value out of relation R and relation S? That will be the R union, the value of X R union S of X comma Y. Okay, that's the thing here. And these things will be explained very nicely with the examples. So let's just remember all these things so we can see all these things in the example practically. Next, so the next one is intersection. So it will be R intersection S in crisp sets. Now it is analogous to capital X R intersection S of X comma Y, such that capital X R intersection S of X comma Y is equal to minimum of capital X R of X comma Y capital X S of X comma Y. So this is the thing. Intersection means we need to take the minimum value out of R and S. The next one is complement. It's R bar. So it will be X of X R bar of X comma Y such that X R bar of X comma Y is equal to 1 minus X R of X comma Y. Very simple. Next. So the next one is containment. That means whether the R contains S, whether the R is in S or not. How can we see this? So this is containment is X R of X comma Y such that X R of X comma Y less than X S of X comma Y. That means if S is a bigger relation, within that relation, if R relation is existing, then we can say that R contains in S. Simply. Next. So the next one is identity. So phi is analogous to O and capital X is analogous to capital U. Where phi is used in the Christ sets, that means it's a null set. And coming to here, it's a null relation, that is O, and capital X is the complete set and it will be analogous to capital E here. It's a relational matrix having the value 1. So that's the thing. This is called complete relation. Now let's move on to properties. As we know, commutativity, associativity, distributivity, involution and idempotency all holds good for Christ relations also, as they hold good for classical set operations. Similar thing. Okay. And the next things are De Morgan's principles and the excluded middle axioms also hold good for Christ relations. So almost all properties hold good for Christ relations also. What are the properties hold good for Christ sets? So exactly same Christ sets and Christ relations. But the problem is here the null relation O and the complete relation capital E are analogous to null set phi and the whole set capital X. Okay, these are the small differences, so we need to take care. So this is everything regarding the operations and properties of Crisp relations. Yeah, thank you so much for 1096 plus subscriptions. And if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video with your friends and colleagues, please share with friends and colleagues. And if you haven't subscribed till date, please do subscribe and try to press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. And I like to cover all relations here. That means maybe the left out relation is composition from Crisp relations, and fuzzy relations are there, and tolerance, and the other thing is also there. So all these things will be covered in the further videos. So please try to follow the YouTube channel so that you will get the complete knowledge of fuzzy logics. Thank you. Thank you so much.